madam president dear colleagues in line with treaty obligations the commission has a long tradition of consulting with those affected by a new policy or initiative and those involved in implementing it. the commission believes that consultation is an essential tool for producing high quality proposals and increasing the legitimacy of eu action. the commission is constantly striving to ensure that its public consultations are as inclusive as possible and has taken several measures to this end. since 2002 all policy initiatives that undergo an impact assessment and green papers must be preceded by public consultations respecting a set of general principles and minimum standards. since 2010 roadmaps are published early in the planning process to allow stakeholders to be aware of proposals the commission is planning to make and to be involved and to give feedback from the very early stages of policy preparation. since 2012 the minimum period for open public consultation has been extended from 8 to 12 weeks to facilitate shareholder response. currently the commission is carrying out a review of its consultation policy. the result of any consequent refinements to the consultation process will be announced in the planned follow up to the 2010 smart regulation communication. a public consultation seeking stakeholder views on the appropriateness of the existing consultation practices will be launched soon and will feed into the review. regarding the language regime, I would emphasise that stakeholders can provide answers to Commission consultations in all official languages. however, while making the consultation documents themselves available in all EU languages could further facilitate stakeholder responses, resources available for translation are very limited for obvious budgetary reasons. the Commission must therefore prioritise the many competing demands on its translation services. the Commission is legally obliged to first ensure that all legislative texts are translated into all the official languages of the EU and that other legal obligations are respected. meeting this obligation takes up the bulk of available translation capacity. only once it has fulfilled these obligations can the Commission decide on how to make the most efficient use of the remaining resources. it needs to reconcile a wide variety of competing demands while making the best and most proportionate use of the resources available. to the extent allowed by the limited available resources, the Commission therefore seeks to translate as many other documents as possible beyond what is legally mandated. thus, for instance, green papers and white papers are in principle translated into all languages since they are considered a political priority for consultation purposes. the Commission is therefore doing all it can to make important consultation documents available in as many EU languages as possible. the fact remains, however, that the Commission does not have the resources to make all consultation documents available in all EU languages. thank you very much.